I want to pose a question to you from those two verses, just briefly this morning. I want to ask you, what's in your hand? What's in your hand? In the wake of the most recent mass school shooting, a little debate came out this week. Reading some of it, talked about the pros and cons of what is being taught in and around our school. And two thematic principles came up. One was morals and the other was values. And debate went on for, it can go on and on endlessly. And I kept, especially when you put morality in a relative sense. In other words, what's wrong to you is not necessarily wrong to me. That's the relativism that's connected to morality. Values tend to take on a more personal tone. It's a personal application that is really advanced for individuals, for people in general, and then young people, and then educators, then parents. Then there's the church that has her role. In advancing a moral narrative when it comes to young people. Yeah. Well, amen. And I looked at that and I thought about that as it relates to the verses that we just read. Because talent number two, man, in this passage, he had, if you will, both good morals and good values as it relates to being a good steward over what the Lord has already blessed him. I'm simply saying, by way of introduction, my brothers and sisters, you need to know what's in your hand. Oh, it's just two talents. What are they worth? What can I do with two talents? When you recognize the origin of those talents, the Lord expects for you to do great things with them. Reread the text, you'll see. God is saying, I'm not giving you anything for you to merely brag or boast about. What I'm offering you, I want you to offer it again, that it might gain a return. No time to sit on what the Lord has blessed us with. Too many today, we'd rather sit on God's blessing rather than advance, or invest what the Lord has blessed us with. I'm telling you the truth, children. Now is not the time. To sit on anything that originates from our God. God doesn't bless anybody just for blessing's sake. God doesn't bless anyone just for us to have an opportunity to brag about. Look what the Lord has done for me. No, because if he blessed you with it, you better know this morning that he wants you to take that blessing, and ultimately be a greater blessing to someone else. Sit on it. You can't hold it. You can't covet it. Because ultimately it doesn't really belong to you. It belongs to the Lord. He blessed us with it. He blessed us with it. And listen, when God takes time to bless us, then we ought to remember to take time to bless somebody else. I wonder who you've been a blessing to this week. Who have you thanked? Just think. Now, don't think too hard. But who have you really been a blessing to this week? And listen, and it was just out of nowhere. They didn't even know how to respond to you blessing them. And on the other hand, who blessed you this past week? Unexpectedly, you weren't looking for it, and all of a sudden it showed up right there in the midst of your spiel, and you trying to tell me you still can't find something to be thankful for? Come on, somebody. Oh, what about the two talents? I only got two talents.
Yeah.
I only have two. What's two? Huh? Just two. Amen. Amen. Two is better than one.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody, huh?
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. At least two represents a measure of agreement.
Yeah.
From scripture. Yeah. Number two. How can they walk together? How can two walk together unless they are in agreement?
Right.
In other words, there's got to be some giving and some taking.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. It's got to be some advancing and it's got to be some submission.
Yeah. Yeah.
Got to know that. Listen, but ultimately, children, you got to know what's in your hand.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Do you really value what's in your hand?
Well,
I wonder about that sometimes when it comes to the church. Amen. People feel like I can't do much. I can't do what Sister So-and-so do. Now, I can't do what Brother So-and-so do. Amen. And you ought to know this morning, that's not why the Lord even created you. Because if both of you had the same identical traits and gifts, one of you would be unnecessary. I'm so glad the Lord doesn't do cookie cutter Christian. Y'all hear me? I'm glad the Lord is an individual God. He's a unique Savior. He knows how to meet each one of us right at the point of our very need. Oh yeah, what he has done for others, he can do for you. He may not, but he is able. What's in your hand, man? You have two talents. Two talents. And when you look at it again, the word reminds us that he had received the two talents. They had come from the Lord, his Lord there. Yeah. The imagery is that God is the originator of all that is good, and that all that is beneficial, God is the originator of that.
Yeah.
Like health and strength.
Yeah.
Like a sane mind.
Yeah.
Lord, like good health.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Huh? Like a reasonable portion of health and strength. Yeah. God is the originator of that. You ought to be glad that you're in here this morning and you still got half of your mind. Could have lost it all when we was out there in the world.
Yeah.
Amen. Some of us did lose it all. God, thanks be to God, God got a reciprocal plan. Amen. That God will return to us. The prophet Joel said the Lord will return to us that the locust and the canker worm ate.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Some of y'all from the country, y'all know what canker worm is. Locusts are. Be careful. They'll annihilate. Amen. You've been y'all. But God is the one. Yes, he will. He knows how to replenish. Somebody know what I'm talking about.
Yes,
you got to learn. Amen. To be faithful over a few things that the Lord has placed in your hand. Said he received two talents. Came and said, Lord, you have delivered unto me two talents. Huh? And there's value in those two talents.
Yeah,
Don't let the number two fool you.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Because he's reminding us that on the other side of two is talents.
Yeah.
Talentos. But the Lord blesses you.
Yeah.
Amen. Blesses you indeed.
Yeah.
Yes, he does. He's able to do it.
Yes, he is.
The word
yes,
said, The word said he delivered unto him his two talents. And behold, the latter part of verse 22 says, and I have gained two others beside them. Now how in the world he going to gain two more? He had to make an investment. Come on close. Now, some of us are looking for stuff to return to us that we ain't made no investment in. You've got to learn. And it's a learning curve that. You've got to learn how to say, Lord, what you have blessed me with, I cannot hold this all to myself. Now, come on, somebody. It's going to bubble up inside of you. It's got to come out. Sometimes it comes out at the most strategic time. Those who are receiving that will wonder, well, where did that come from? I don't even like you. Came from the Lord. You ain't got to like me. Bible don't say nothing about like. Amen. But you ought to love. Amen. Be one another. And I have loved you. Have I got a witness here? Yeah, he said, listen, I gained two other talents beside them. You made an investment. You and I in here this morning have got to learn to make an investment. And investments do not come once a week. Investments is a lifestyle. How many times have you been known to be a giving person? Are you known for the gift that you give? Are you known for being a blessing to somebody? Now, come on now. Are you really known for being a spiritual philanthropist? You don't mind giving because you know God knows how to give back to you. The little cliche we grew up with, so long as I owe you, you'll never be broke. Some of y'all know, huh? You got folks that owe you right now, right? So in one sense, you'll never be completely broke. Amen. You say, but Pastor, it's too long, man. I got to start charging interest on that. No. Remember, if the Lord had charged us interest, on what he had blessed us with, we'd never be able to stand upright before him and say, God, can you put me up a payment plan? Back in the old days, a layaway plan. God said, no, I'm not going to do that. What is he reminding us here? Just a few things. Children, he's saying, you've got to learn to be an investment. You've got to invest. If you want to enlarge, you got to invest. Amen. What is he investing? He has his two talents. You have your talent. You have your gift. You have your lifestyle. You have your spirit of generosity. And you don't mind sharing it. Amen. On a consistent basis. Even when you know the individual doesn't deserve it. When I think on those terms, I think about how God has blessed me. And I know I didn't deserve it. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. But God got a way of sending perpetual blessings your way. To where every time you turn around, he just keeps on making a way for you. Somebody know what I'm talking about. I'm about halfway through with this sermon. But listen, it's just a blessing to know that even when my barrel get low, I know God will move in just in a nip of time. Oh, yes, he will. I've seen him do it. Some of y'all have seen him do it. Oh, yeah. When the barrel get low, I tell you, God knows how to put something in the barrel. Amen. When money get low, God knows how to extend you. Come on, somebody. You may not have it, but God knows how to give you enough sense to call in and let me get an extension so I won't be sitting up here in the dark. Somebody know what I'm talking about. Cover get low. The Lord will send somebody by. With a sack of groceries there. Just to help tide you over a little bit. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. The Lord blesses in many different ways. And you've got to be alert to how the Lord wants to bless you. Oh, yes, he does. Benjamin Mays was said that if he was being installed as the new president at Morehouse, and he was there, And the committee declared, as they were giving him this.